If you're thinking about it, Cliff is talking about it. Afternoons, 3 to 7 on the Talk of Chicago, 1690 WVON.
Superintendent of the Chicago Police Department, Superintendent Jody Weiss. How are you, sir?
I'm doing well, Cliff. How are you?
Good, good. Thanks for being on with us. We appreciate it. Before I go into anything, you know what we're going to talk about. Why don't you just start and tell us what brought about this August 17th meeting and what was the precursor of the things that you talked about and decided this is what we're going to do?
We've actually been speaking for quite a while with David Kennedy and a lot of our law enforcement partners like the United States Attorney's Office, the Cook County State's Attorney's Office, ATF, DEA, FBI, United States Marshal Service. And what we were talking about for several months before this meeting took place was how to adopt a practice of dealing with group behavior that has been very successful in other cities and apply it to Chicago. Mm-hmm. First thing we wanted to do is get the support of all the law enforcement, which we were able to obtain. And we looked at it this way, that for a long time, the United States Attorney's Office has been engaged in Project Safe Neighborhoods, where they actually focus on young men coming out of prison and try to give them an idea of what the consequences would be if they were to continue in their criminal behavior, but then also give them some alternatives. So this program that we're using, this anti-gang or anti-violence initiative, is kind of like the PSN program, maybe on steroids a little bit, because instead of focusing on the individual, we're focusing on the group. And we took that philosophy right to these guys on August the 17th. And I would want to clear up one thing. There's been a lot of talk about negotiation, and that couldn't be farther from the truth. Anyone mm-hmm. in that room, and I think even some of the gangbangers supported this, would say there was no negotiation. This was a monologue. It was not a dialogue.
Mm-hmm.
And we laid
mm-hmm.
out, you know, what would happen if these guys engaged in violence acts. We might have our eyes on them in a narcotics investigation or a weapons investigation, but if they commit an act of violence, then we would just give them a lot more attention. But the good thing, Cliff, is we also gave these young men an alternative. There was a social worker there who actually offered them jobs, and one of the young men actually is pursuing that, and I certainly hope he's able to take advantage of the job opportunities from this. So it was not just all, all stick. There was a carrot involved, too. And we gave them opportunities. I've heard a lot of talk about how people want jobs. That was offered to them. So that's what we tried to do, is send a very clear message, is we have to stop the violence. Too many of our young people are being killed predominantly by gang members. 60% of the homicides in Chicago can be attributed to the gangs. And we said, you know what, we've got to try something new. We can't sit back and just wait. We've got to try something new. And this seemed like a good time to try this new initiative. And like I said, it's not new in the law enforcement community. It's been around for quite a few years. It's been successful in other cities. And we thought we could adopt it here to Chicago and see if we could help reduce the violence that unfortunately affects too many of our neighborhoods.
Well, I'm pleased you've told us that, because that is one of the things, as you know, Superintendent, that people have been complaining about, that you're negotiating. And that, as you just pointed out, is not, there was no negotiation.
True. If they
yeah.
if they knew Brian Sexton from the Cook County State's Attorney's Office, I think they would understand there was no negotiation. Mm-hmm. We had two of our senior staff speak to them, Jimmy Jackson, our assistant superintendent over operations, our new deputy superintendent over patrol, Ernie Brown, one of the assistant United States attorneys laid out the federal ramifications of their continued criminal activity, and then Brian spoke from the state issues that they would face. And it was just four people. They've spoke their mind, they laid out the facts, and then that was pretty much it.
Okay, and then the good thing I'm hearing is that you did offer alternatives.
Yeah, we thought that was important.
That is important, yeah.
It's not really fair to come in with just a one-sided approach. We always hope, and there's not a person in law enforcement that doesn't hope, that when some of these young men come out of prison that they have reformed, and we wanted to give them opportunities. And I think what I hear all the time from the young folks is we need jobs, we need jobs, we need jobs. And that's where we had an individual, I think, from the West Side Public Health Facility, I think, I could be wrong on that,
mm-hmm.
who actually was there and said, if you call me, I will do everything I can to get you a job. And he does a He's got a history of placing folks who are coming in out of prison, and we thought that would be a good alternative from having these young men go back into the gang lifestyle. Here they could actually go out and earn an honest living and stay away from the crime world often associated with gangs.
What about, Superintendent, the statement that there is no organizational structure as there used to be? So the these folks, there really is no leadership.
Well, yes.
Your intelligence.
Larry Hoover and Jeff Ford,
yeah.
They're
mm-hmm.
over with. The one guy that controls 10,000 members of the Gangster Disciples, those are done. But the guys we brought in were like fraction or faction leaders. And if you follow the money, Cliff, to say that there's no leadership whatsoever is kind of ridiculous.
Mm-hmm.
There is tons of money that's involved with the drug trade that is being handled predominantly by the gang. So to say no one is in charge is a little bit misleading. And we brought in guys who were not the new Jeff Fords or the Larry Hoovers, but these were the guys that might control a sect, a group of 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 guys. But we know through our intelligence that everybody in that meeting that was invited in has influence, at least in their world, albeit perhaps a small world, of guys who have a history of violence and who are engaged in the gang activity within the 11th District.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So at this point, then, is it true, Superintendent Weiss, as a reporter, that you're going to do the same thing on the South Side, or do you want to comment on that?
Right now, this is a pilot program, and Cliff, this is one of those things. I hope people aren't thinking that it's an overnight fix. We're going to have a lot more of these meetings with the gang members and try to really show that we're serious about this and try and lay out some of the ramifications for the activity. In most cities, it's taken multiple meetings for the messages to sink through. And so we're going to evaluate this in the 11th District first. If it does work and it's successful and we see a significant reduction in violence like has been achieved in other cities. I believe Cincinnati had a 40% reduction in homicides. Of course, we would expand this to other parts of the city. But Chicago is a big city, and we want to look at it first, evaluate it. Maybe we just need to tweak it a little bit, or maybe we need to rethink the entire process entirely. But there's been so many successes in other cities that we just felt it would be a prudent effort to try it here. I know David Kennedy is really behind it here, and he's kind of the architect behind this from the academic standpoint. And the fact that we have the full support and collaboration of all of our law enforcement partners, we're confident will work. We may have to tweak it a little bit, but if it does work, we will expand it.
The what is your response to the press conference that the gang members had today?
Well, I mean, I think it means we probably got their attention. Which is a good thing.
Mm-hmm.
We want them to start thinking about how group behavior will also bring about group responsibility. I won't comment much more on it because I'm really not aware of what happened.
What happened, yeah. Mm-hmm.
But I'm glad that we got their attention and they're at least thinking about this now.
And that will there will be more meetings then with these same individuals?
Well, either them or a few others.
A few others.
We are going to be focused in the 11th District.
If you're thinking about it, Cliff is talking about it. Afternoons, 3 to 7 on the Talk of Chicago, 1690 WVON.